So the next item on our program is the award of the Wieringa-Rengerink 2016 prize for the best dissertation. University of Groningen is happy to award this prize for the best dissertation defended in 2016, and we will do that for the third time here at this ceremony. The prize consists of a substantial financial support. You can see the amount here on my, for your left-hand side, to be spent on academic development, as we say it broadly. So at the request of the Rector Magnificus, the deans of the faculties have been invited to submit candidate-winning dissertations and a short motivation. All nominated dissertations have been awarded with the verdict cum laude. And a jury consisting of former rectors Bleuming, Boscher, Schwartz and myself has evaluated the four nominations in the end. And I list the nominations in alphabetical order of the last names of the candidates. And the first one is by Jordi van Gestel, and the title of the dissertation is The Evolution of Bacterial Cell Differentiation and Multicellular Organization. And he was a student at the Faculty of Science and Engineering. Second one is by Rutger Gjaltema, and the title of the dissertation is Modifications of Collagen and Chromatin in ECM-related Disease, Uncovering Therapeutic Targets for Fibrosis and Cancer at the Faculty of Medical Sciences. Third is Evert de Haan, and the title of the dissertation is Creating, Managing and Monitoring Customer Value in the On and Offline World. And this thesis was defended at the Faculty of Economics and Business. And number four is by Nigel Hamilton, and the title of the dissertation is Commander-in-Chief, FDR's Battle with Churchill, 1943. And Dr. Hamilton graduated from the Faculty of Arts. So it goes without saying that all dissertations are of exceptional quality, and I congratulate all four nominated candidates with their nomination. So please give them a hand. This year the jury has decided to award the Wieringa-Rengerink Prize for the best dissertation to two winners. So basically you could say that the jury did a lousy job, but we could not decide on a single winner. And only a single winner would get 7,500 euro. But we added some money from another fund, the Nicolaas Melerius Foundation, was so kind to allow us to top it up to 5,000 euro each to both winners. So let me explain who the winners are. And I'm very happy that both winners can be here today, despite living in Switzerland and the US. So they took some effort to be here. Well, thank you for that. So allow me to introduce each winner by reading some lines of the jury report. And the first winner is Dr. Jordi van Gestel. Maybe you can come to the fore so we can see your tall. Okay. So you're from the Faculty of Science and Engineering, and the title of your dissertation was, let me repeat it, The Evolution of Bacterial Cell Differentiation and Multicellular Organization. In his dissertation, van Gestel shows that bacterial populations are not simple, but highly structured. Bacterial cells are even able to gamble and spread risks. I didn't know that, but yeah. Van Gestel uses mathematical models to describe these complex interactions and dynamics of bacterial populations. And let me not dive into all the details of the dissertation, but let me share some of the observations that the jury made with you. The first one is that 7 out of the 8 chapters have been published, all of them with Jordi van Gestel as a first author. One article is in PLOS Biology, and it was highlighted as a cover story in Science, while another of your articles was highlighted in Nature. Secondly, van Gestel has completed his work within 4 years, which is a remarkable achievement. Let me share that by experience. The project was financed through grant applications, also written by Dr. von Gestel himself. Thirdly, five chapters were not co-authored by his thesis advisor, Franjo Wijsing, who we should give some honor, I think. But not writing with you is also an honor. But by self-selected collaborators at the universities of Harvard, Princeton, and Jena. And lastly, Jordi van Gestel is also able to communicate over his work. He presented his work at a TEDx meeting and was active in the very nice event that we had with Studium Generale some time ago with the famous Richard Dawkins. So we're more than happy to award you with the prize, the Wieringa-Rengerink Prize for Best Dissertation Defended in 2016. And may I invite you to collect the prize, and we will give it in a symbolic way like this, and then we make a photo. So congratulations, Jordi van Gestel. And now we go to the second winner, Dr. Nigel Hamilton. Maybe you can come to the fore, we can see you. Yeah. And the title of Dr. Hamilton's dissertation is Commander-in-Chief, FDR's Battle with Churchill 1943. So Dr. Hamilton has been so kind to attend the ceremony, coming all the way from Boston, I think, US. So thank you very much for doing that. You're kind of an exceptional winner, I think, today. So I would like to invite you in a minute to share some of your thoughts with us. Dr. Hamilton's dissertation, let me explain that, is a biography of Franklin Delano Roosevelt and focuses on the important year 1943. And I should explain that Dr. Hamilton is an experienced biographer, having published about the lives of US presidents and more. But in Commander-in-Chief, he illuminates the essential battle between Churchill and Roosevelt on the strategy how to beat Nazi Germany. If I'm wrong, you should correct me in a minute. And Dr. Hamilton uses new documents, like personal notes, to partly rewrite history and to bring the writing of a biography into academic research. An important element is the use of the idea of a turning point in a person's life, explaining an essential change of behavior over time in making decisions. So the dissertation is extremely well written and truly innovative in various respects. And it's a wonderful combination of meticulous research and a very personal narrative that reaches out to the reader. Let me explain that Dr. Hamilton's dissertation has attracted a lot of attention in the media, not only in the US, but also in Europe. And given the time frame of current politics in the two continents, let me be kind of, try to be objective and thinking about Hamburg and the G20 and somebody who was present there. We are extremely happy that you, Dr. Hamilton, are willing to deliver a short acceptance speech for our academic community about the issues that you would like to raise. And I think we find today's occasion the best possible audience to accept your speech here. So may I invite you, after receiving the prize, to say a few words to us.
Sure.
Congratulations.